The most interesting thing about King Charles I is that he was 5'6" tall at the start of his reign, but only 4'8" tall at the end of it. Because of...
Ireland, Cromwell, Lord Protector of England,
Puritan,
born in 1599 and died in 1658.
September,
I was at first
only
MP for Huntingdon,
but then
he led the Ironside Cavalry at Marston Moor in 1644 and won. Then he founded the new model army, and praise be, beat the Cavaliers at Naseby, and the king fled at north like a bat to the Scots.
But under the terms of John Pym's solemn league and covenant, the Scots handed King Charles I over to...
Oliver Cromwell, Lord Protector of England,
and his wards,
born in 1599 and 1658.
September.
But, alas!
Oy vey!
Disagreement then broke out
between
the Presbyterian Parliament and the military, who meant to have an independent bent, and so... The Second Civil War broke out, and the Roundhead ranks faced the Cavaliers at Preston Links, and the king lost again, silly thing.
Stupid king.
And Cromwell sent Colonel Pride to purge the House of Commons of the Presbyterian Royalists, leaving behind only the rump Parliament,
which appointed a High Court at Westminster Hall to indict Charles I for tyranny. Charles was sentenced to death, even though he refused to accept that the court had jurisdiction.
Say goodbye to his head.
Oh, King Charles laid his head on the block.
January 1649.
Down came the axe. And
in the silence that followed, the only sound that could be heard was a solitary giggle. From
Cromwell, Lord Protector of England,
all
night, born in 1599 and in 1658,
September.
Then he smashed
Ireland,
set up the Commonwealth,
and more.
He crushed the Scots at Worcester and beat the Dutch at sea in 1653, and then he dissolved the rump Parliament, and with Lambert's consent wrote the instrument of government, under which Oliver was protector at last.